Hi, my name is Patricia Regier.
I've already clicked a button here. After you have updated your settings, go back into a new Zoom meeting and look around. So I clicked AI Companion, and it's giving a disclaimer too. The content may be inaccurate, so check for accuracy. So I'm going to click Got It. AI Companion is on. It does not use any audio, video, or chat, or screen sharing, or attachments, or poll results, and whiteboard and reactions. That's good to know, and always check for accuracy. So I've just clicked AI Companion, and at the right, and I will connect the recent video that talks about all the settings and updating those. And just share what is this and what are the implications. So AI Companion, it is here at the bottom. You can turn it on and off. You can have it already ticked off in your settings so that it's even an option for you. Now, if you're not wanting to record a video at all, if there's confidentiality, you want to think about your policies, whether individually as a business or entrepreneur or as an organization as well. But what the AI Companion can do is help with a summary. Now, some of that information ahead of time, take a look and read that when it's up. But it talks about it's not including everything, including it's not talking about the chat or the polls or what's being shared on screen.
This is another really good, important reason why you should read out the comments or questions in chat, especially if someone is only communicating that way and not on mic or camera. But in particular for the AI summary to be included and have a voice in this option, you need to read out the aspects that are being typed in chat, because that's not an automatic thing. So just to pay attention to that as well and consider it.
So it is about what is being talked about, and it can even include action items. So it can be very helpful for that minute taking. It's very interesting. And I would recommend that you still take your regular notes and then take a look and compare, because it does give the cautionary that it's not without potential errors. So you want to compare and take a look. But it's great. I've had it on and I've had a couple meetings, and participants get that notification too. It's not a full recording. It's not a full they said this, they said that. It's about giving a snapshot, a summary, a synopsis of what happened and giving you some suggested action items, which is really helpful. But it doesn't pick up everything. So I've been testing this, and you need to be very clear and intentional, clear with your speech, intentional. You may even say an action item that we need to do next is, so that summary maybe can pick that up a little bit easier, and be intentional about that as well. So when you've got the AI Companion on, what is really amazing, when I clicked it here at the bottom, navigation, and anybody can then click that during the meeting. So especially if they've come in late, what they can do is say, catch me up, which this is so exciting. So it's working on that right now. And based on the meeting transcript, and it goes into more details of what has happened, you can even give it a thumbs up, so which is a thank you. So when you then go to the three dots on the right hand side, that panel that's opened up right beside catch me up, I'm going to click the three dots, and then it goes back to what those initial options were, and I'm going to say, was my name mentioned? And yes, my name was mentioned by other meeting participants in the transcript. So it's not giving me what was said. What topics were discussed? I'm going to click that now as well and see what it comes up with. The main topic discussed so far in the meeting transcript is AI companion feature. This is so exciting. I find all of these new options super exciting, but you definitely want to consider, how does it fit for you? How would your participants feel? Maybe explaining that, yes, it is going to mention names, like it mentioned mine. So let's mention someone else's name, Joe Smith. I'm thinking, like, think of different ways of how you can test it. And in a safe group, you know, test the potential pros and cons of something, and then how you're going to put it into practice as well. So I am going to then click, and an action item for Joe is to compare the summary. Is it accurate? So I'm saying all of this. Now, I'm not right now looking at the transcript because when you do, when you have something open, all the navigation options at the bottom become smaller. So I'm clicking the three dots with more, and I'm taking a look for captions and view full transcript, which I'm just clicking save. And I'm taking a look. So it's only picking up from where I clicked it. It's not giving me previous things. And it's telling me at the top here, closed captioning transcript are being generated. Okay. So I will also link those videos that I talk about closed captioning. So if you weren't recording for confidentiality, then you might not want to have all of these things activated, but for accessibility, you do. So I'm going to close full transcript, and I want to turn off the, for myself, the closed captioning. I'm just hiding them because I want others to have options to access them. Now, definitely for accessibility and being inclusive in your meetings, you want to have some of these things activated, but you want to discuss all of the as I said already, the pros and cons for all of it, just so that you can be clear, maybe with a notification that everything discussed here is confidential, if that's that kind of training or meeting. And that you have AI, for example, activated for that summary assist and support, which could be an accessibility option too for somebody to help them take minutes as well. So I'm going to click here to what are the action items, and let's see what it comes up with, because I've talked about an action item for Joe that they are going to have. Okay, so I did specifically say what Joe was going to do, what they were going to do. I'm sorry, but the meeting transcript does not provide any specific action items mentioned after the meeting. So it's not picking up everything necessarily, but every new thing is growing and learning. Now, Zoom specifically says it's not pulling from our content to learn, but it's probably, you know, like, I'll do a thumbs down for that. Thank you for the feedback. So it's tracking that stuff potentially. And you also in your settings have the option of what Zoom can pull from data, but it's not specific data. It's not identifying information. It's so that they can get better with this kind of thing that could be a real asset and help to many. So, you know, I'm going to say again, Carrie, they are going to be double checking also the summary of the AI compared to notes and what, what was beneficial. So what I want to show you is after the meeting, what happens as well. So let's just try one more time. And maybe it needed a couple minutes you know, also it's not for maybe a 5-minute meeting, but it did already pull something. So it's not catching the action items. What I want you to do is compare the meeting minutes after the meeting. I want you this action item. I want you to do this. And what this is comparing the summary. So I'm trying to give it enough, but to test it. You want to try, and then again, may not have had enough chance to really pull. So, you know, but the summary is really, what I've found is very interesting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to end the meeting and let's take a look at the summary and where you're going to get that. So end the meeting. So if you're doing a recording, you definitely want to let the recording finish processing if it's going to the cloud or if it's going onto your computer, and that, you know, applies for everything. AI Companion is over on the left, but on the right-hand side is the bar to bring it down further if I was scrolling, but I'm seeing here on the left, AI Companion. And then I am going to today's Zoom meeting. And here is where I am seeing, that's where you would go back to other summaries. And so I'm going to check on that as well. So a quick recap, it's giving me a little summary. She advised users. Now, what would be interesting to test as well, I have my pronouns in Zoom as she, her. I'm wondering for someone with the pronouns they, them, if it would also pick that up accurately. So test that as well. I mean, it might not, you know, you can correct those things, but those are things that you don't want to take for granted that it is accurate, and correct that as well. And the summary here, so we've got a quick recap and a summary. In a longer meeting, this might be longer. Next steps. Carrie, now the spelling wasn't what I was thinking in my head when I said the name Carrie. I was thinking K-E-R-R-Y. So that's one thing that would need to be corrected as well. And this, so I can share this, I can edit it, which is great. So, and I would, you know, correct that as well, and then click save, and then sharing. Let's take a look. So I might want to send it to myself, but it's not letting me because, and what it does is in my email already, it sent it to me. So journal share, it already gives it to me. And then it has the option to edit it right there as well. What you are seeing here is download pictures. So you're not you know, you might have to take that step as well. This is new. It also supports additional languages, which is very exciting. And then it's asking for the accuracy of the summary. So it's asking for that feedback because the exciting thing about anything new is that it's growing and improving, to not discount it. But if there's a reason to not have something because of some of those, you know, beginning steps. So we're seeing again here, as soon as I open the meeting, we've got these notifications. So if there are certain things at this stage that you can't implement it, but you're going to keep testing it, you might put that in your calendar, even in 3 months, to check back on it, to not discount it forever, because all of these options are constantly growing. And I encourage you to also update on a regular basis. I'll link in the description some of related videos. And if this is helpful, I always really appreciate the like, comments, share it. And of course, I would really appreciate if you would subscribe as well. All that does is tell me, should I keep making these videos? So I appreciate this. My name is Patricia Regier. Until next time, take care. was editing this video for you, I noticed that there is something else that I didn't test out here in the navigation screen at the very bottom of my Zoom meeting. So I am going to click on AI Companion, and that opens the panel on the right. And then I have here options for stop summary as well. So first of all, the little arrow, or some people call it a caret, right beside AI Companion, I'm going to open it. Who can ask questions to AI Companion? All participants only when they join, or only hosts. And the summary is what I want to see what happens when I click that button as well. So first of all, catch me up. I'll just see what it comes up with this short, already meeting. And then I'm going to click stop summary, and let's see. Meeting summary is off. So there might be a point where you're talking about something a little bit more delicate that you want to turn it off, and you can just tell your group, oh, it's turned off, and then you can start it back up again, and meeting summary is on. So it does have that option as well. I just want to point that out because I just noticed that, and I would love to hear your comments. What are you interested in for future videos as well? Thanks for checking this out.